New satellite images from Lake Okeechobee show about 45% of the water is still covered with blue-green algae. NOAA tells us this picture is the most accurate that they've had recently because the weather when they took the picture was crystal clear. This is an improvement from a month ago. This picture from July 14th showed 80% of the lake was covered with algae. That tainted water was released into the Coosawhatchie. It's a big reason why we have so much algae in our local waterways. It has been 1 week since this pilot program started to try and clean up the algae. NBC2's Alex Howard is live in Cape Coral with an update on the progress.
Yeah, it's still pretty bad out here. In fact, when I first arrived, I actually felt nauseous because of the smell. And the people we spoke to who live out here say that the cleanup efforts haven't done much. Usually, that's the sound of progress. But after a week of being hopeful, people living along the water aren't satisfied.
Pump out was a total failure. They pumped out 10,000 gallons of slime and just shook their head.
Crews have pumped out more than 85,000 gallons, tanker trucks full. But the film of blue-green algae was still visible in North Fort Myers at Waterway Estates and in Cape Coral on Friday.
When they're pumping an oil skim out, you're taking paper thin off, and it goes through the pumps easy. It's oily. Mm-hmm. When you're pumping this out, they were taking an inch to inch and a half off. That's just too much water.
The county says it's happy with the results of the $700,000 pilot program so far. They say they plan on reviewing their results and refining their strategy on the cleanup efforts going forward. But until then, the algae is here to stay.
I guess it was a bargain at $750,000 that we got the folks to come out and at least try.
Crews working here in Clipper Bay in Cape Coral wrapped up their cleaning just before 5 o'clock, and the county says that they'll be back next week to continue their efforts. Live in Cape Coral, Alex Howard, NBC2.